My name is Annie Christensen, and I work here at Houston Methodist Hospital for the ENT specialist with two plastic surgeons, and I am a medical esthetician. Sunscreen can work in two main ways. It can be a physical sunscreen and a chemical sunscreen. So a physical sunscreen really reflects the sun, and so usually that's a zinc oxide or a mineral, so that it can reflect the sun off of us. And it does keep the skin even cooler. A chemical sunscreen absorbs the sun and basically holds it so it can't get in and damage the skin. The best sunscreen for your face is going to be a sunscreen that you use, first of all. It needs to be comfortable, it needs to feel good on the skin, it needs to be able to be under a makeup, because you want to wear sunscreen every day. Generally, you want to find one that is maybe oil-free, lightweight, and it says for the face on it. Sunscreen can cause acne. Anyone that does have acne knows that many things can irritate an acne skin. So you do have to look for something that does say oil-free for acne, and sometimes even then you just have to try different ones to find the one that works for you. Wearing your sunscreen under makeup is a very good idea because you need to have that sunscreen on every single day. Now, a lot of times your makeup does have sunscreen in it, and your moisturizer does have sunscreen in it. So you should always just call those a bonus sunscreen. Put on your regular sunscreen for your face every single day, and then layer those other things on it. Sunscreen can expire, and most sunscreens, all I think, are required by the FDA to have an expiration date on them. And usually a sunscreen is really only good for 1 year. And you should really keep it in a cool, dry place. So anything over a 35 is going to give you basically a total block. But having a 50 or 100 or higher does help. It's just it makes it a longer period of time. You're not necessarily getting a higher sunscreen, but you're getting longer time with it. So that's the main difference.